What is up, Team Happy and Fit? Happy freaking Tuesday. I'm just stoked. You know, I was looking around social media and even on our team page, and I don't know, did you guys just feel it today with all the transformations? It was so beautiful just to see so many. Lauren, I saw so many of your coaches posting their transformations. Kayla, I saw that you shared like really raw posts, and I have to tell you guys a story. I think what's really cool about my church is that it's in Silicon Valley and it's a church plant. And so they really speak to entrepreneurs. So I feel like it's the daily dose of PD as well as spiritual development, which is awesome. But, you know, the leadership team at my church, they're really heavily into personal development. So you'll hear people, them talking about John Maxwell. I actually gave our lead pastor The Happiness Advantage by Sean Anker, and he read it and he's like, this was so good. And I was like, right. So he speaks a lot to startups, entrepreneurs, people just working here. And I love it. It is so good. And I couldn't really put my finger on why it's so good. And it hit me this weekend. Eric and I went to SoCal. If you don't know, we live in Northern California. So we live by San Francisco, Oakland. We're 20 minutes from Oakland. And Eric's from Orange County. He didn't have a normal growing up. I say that's not normal. It's not normal for you to grow up in the OC and you're just weird, born and raised there, right? And so his whole family is still there. And so we went to go visit them, and we went to this church called Saddleback. I'm sure some of you have heard of Rick Warren. He has a podcast. Anyway, I'm at Saddleback, and I want to say Brooke. I don't know why, but it's Saddleback. And it was so good. The message was so amazing. It was talking about what side of the comma are you living on? When life is hard, are you playing into life is hard? Or are you seeing that there's something that comes after this, right? What side are you playing on? I was like, wow, what a phenomenal message. However, there's something missing. And that's kind of what I took from it. When everyone else is like, this is so good, like life-changing. I'm like, what is it? I can't put my finger on it. Then I realized the pastor who was telling this, you know, giving this message. Oh, and Eric brought all the notes here because he's just wonderful. He didn't share a personalized story of when he was living life before the comma. He was talking at us, inspiring us, telling us how to be in a really inspiring and wonderful way. You know, we have to see the unseen and all these things. And I was just thinking, he says, never put a period where God put a comma. Right? But I was just like, huh. He didn't talk about a story that resonated with that was personalized. Does that make sense? It was such a beautiful message. And then I thought more about it and I was like, dang, like at my church, this is why I love it so much, is that Pastor Andy reveals himself. You know, Pastor Philip reveals himself. When they're talking about temptations, you have Pastor Philip talking about how he had an affair in his old church that he worked at years ago, and how there was restoration and forgiveness, and him and his wife worked through that. And you know, you're just listening to him and you're like, he's just a normal human being. We're all broken. We don't all have our life together, right? Life is hard. Life can be wonderful. Life is all these different things. And I was just thinking like, dang, that's what it is. And I related it to coaching, and that's really kind of my message right now. Is we can talk at people, we can inspire them, we can share with them. I can tell you guys that, you know, building this business is hard, but if I don't give you specifics on how that's hard, you're not gonna connect to that. And it just hit me that I feel more connection and depth with people when they reveal themselves. And we don't have to air our dirty laundry, that's not what I'm saying, but there's a difference at talking at someone versus inviting them in. And I really, truly believe the reason that I've been able to connect and get to where I am today is because I have found this way of communicating with people, being transparent with my story, allowing them to come in and really understand and see who I am. Do you understand what I just said? I know I went kind of like all these crazy things. I heard an amazing message, but there was something missing for me. It was the connection. And I think a lot of times when we're on social media, you guys have an amazing message, but there's a lack of connection. And when I was looking at your stories today, you weren't just sharing before and afters. You were sharing a story of struggle. You were sharing a story of, this took me a full year to get to. Ashley had a phenomenal post. Lauren, I don't know if you can go see it and read it for us, but she talked about, a year ago I was this person, and then today I am this person. A year ago, this is what, I was on 5 medications, and now I'm on a 1 inhaler. And I was just looking at her story and I was just like, man, she's inviting us in to her story. She's not talking at people. She's not saying, hey, here's my before and after. She was inviting people in to this story. And so you can look at your tracker found on the files tab of Team Happy and Fit, and you can be like, check, 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 check. Checked everything off. Why is my business not moving forward? It is hard to teach connection. Connection is something that takes practice. And so when I don't share these stories of like, man, yeah, when you're starting this business, you feel like you have to be further along in order to be credible. And that's a lie. Because we've all gotten here, right? We all had to get there in some way. You think in order to be credible, I have to be making this amount of money in order for people to take me seriously. I built my business with people quitting. That's on them, not on me. And well, actually, like, I'm sure if they were joining me now, it would look a lot different because I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I feel bad for them. Like, I'm thankful they like joined me then, but I don't blame them for leaving, especially the 3 that quit on one day. Do you know how many coaches would have quit after that? Here you are trying to like figure this thing out. Your point, all I had was belief. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to say. I word vomited all the time and I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I didn't know what Emerald meant. I knew that success level was important, but I didn't know what SC meant. I didn't know what these things meant, right? I just did it. And you know, when I look back to see now, I was like, dang, like, you know what got me here was consistency and continuing to push through, but connection. Yeah, thank goodness, Cody. Like, that is awesome. It is amazing to me to see who is still here because all I relied on, what did Lauren Lundberg, you texted me today and you said, thanks for always believing in me. And I think that has been our conversation over the last few weeks. Is you just have always had belief. You just always believe in me. And I'm like, well, she'll say, hey, you know, this happened. I'm like, well, of course it did. I knew it would. I have belief. I have so much belief. Here's gonna rock your world, this quote. You ready for this? I don't think you're ready for this. This quote's good. This quote is this. People let a minimum requirement become their maximum effort. People let a minimum requirement become their maximum effort. Oh, I'm going to expand my network by 5 people. I can do that. Versus going to 10. Or, you know, I'm going to do this amount of my workout or this much of meal planning or only follow one program start to finish and kind of wing it the rest of the time. Or I'm only going to listen to 15 minutes of PD. I'm only going to invite 2 people, right? Where people let their minimum requirement become their maximum effort. SC6. I remember at the time it was SC5. And if you don't know what SC is, it's a really great way to track your business. Honestly, it gives you growth and it's called Success Club. And essentially it's how we all got here. And Success Club is a challenge pack. And you guys, it's not hard to help 3 people a month. Like the fact that that is like the minimum requirement, helping 3 people a month isn't hard, especially when you're working on yourself and sharing your heart and your belief. Because I really believe these are the tools that will change someone's life. I was talking to someone and inviting them saying, hey, would you, like not would you, but hey, I really think you should join our team. And they were saying, no, I'm building this other thing. And I'm like, you have to start that from scratch, and that's awesome, but why wouldn't you utilize tools that already work? Hey, Eric, would you be able to do that somewhere else? Sorry, I'm very distracted. the tools that we have are proven to work, and why wouldn't we use that in our journey? They work. Our nutrition plans, they've been designed by the best to get you the results. These workouts are designed to help you get results, and they do. This entire company has been built on before and afters. I always thought those transformations were fake. Those aren't the right people. Their tattoo is on the other side of their arm. You know, but it was like the reflection in the mirror. But I really didn't think that this was actually a thing that could work. And the crazy part is, it's not a quick fix. The crazy part is, you actually have to put in the work. The crazy part is, when you get up and your alarm goes off, you can't press snooze if that's the only time you can work out, right? The crazy part is that you can get a, like people say, at-home workouts don't work. Have you tried a Shanti program? Have you really tried a Shanti program? Because let me tell you, that stuff works. That ish works, right? So here I am thinking about the tools that we have. Helping three people is not hard. But what I'm thinking is that we are letting a minimum requirement become our maximum effort. And then when we're playing into the minimum, it actually doesn't happen. The growth that you wish to have doesn't happen. The goals that you have them, but they're not happening. Why is that? We're doing the bare minimum. I'm not trying to like talk at you. I'm just having a gut check with my own self. Because when I first started this, going back to what I was saying, is it was SC5. We could get uneven points. And I've hit SC 53 months in a row. And that sounds like so crazy, but you know what's not crazy is consistency. That's all it is I show up for myself and I show up and share my story and I'm tracking. It's so boring, really, when you really think about this. Like, this is really just what I do every day. And I've done it every day for the last 4.5 years. Like, that's kind of psycho and crazy, right? But it's not that hard. But when I first started this, I didn't hit it my first 3 months because I didn't know what it was, or 2 months or something. My first month, I hit SC14 when I hit SC. But after that, I always hit SC5 for a good while. And it was because it was the bare minimum. Check that off my list. Now I can coast. But you know what was hard after that? The next month. I found myself having to overcompensate and push a little bit harder when I went for the bare minimum. Is the quote the people let the minimum requirement become their maximum effort? And then when I realized, I was like, huh, if SC5 is good for me, what if I were to try for SC10? Like, what would happen? What would happen if I were to do that? All I had to do was put in more effort. And so what I want to talk to you tonight is, I'm assuming if you're on this call, there's some desire for you to connect to community. If you're on this call, there's some desire inside of you that's like, what if, maybe me, why not me? If you're on this call, that is my dog opening up a door. If you're on this call, I'm assuming that you're wanting more. And I really do believe that we help our health and finances, help our health with our bodies, we help our health with our mind. Like, there's so many solutions to what we're doing. And I'm assuming if you're on this call, is that first of all, happy and fit is seriously a freaking blessing because all of you are a part of it. The number one, like, most accountability I've ever seen is within our team, that you guys show up. I can count on you for me to be like, man, I don't feel like getting my workout done today. And that's why I posted on team page who got their workout done today, because I was like, I better post in there today because I've got to show up for my crew that breathes belief into me and what I know is possible. You guys help remind me of that. And I hope that I can help remind you of that. So if you're on this call, isn't it freaking cool that the requirement to do this thing is to become the best version of yourself? Where do you find that? And I can't stop talking about this. You don't walk into your job and they're not asking you how your mindset is. They're not asking you how your confidence is. They're not asking you about, you know, what are you struggling with and how can we create solutions to this? They're not asking you about, did you get your workout done at 5 a.m.? Like, did you complete your program? Are you connecting to a positive community that dreams big, right? Are you plugging into a space that makes you a better person? You don't find that. And literally what we get to do helps you to become the best version of you. But the kicker, you can build a business with that. And that's not gross. That's not yucky. That is freaking awesome and powerful because people need health and wellness for life. I talk to countless people who have about 4 monsters a day. I talk to countless people who get fast food 3 times a week. I talk to countless people who don't have any money to do anything. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to say no to experiences and adventures and memories. I don't want to feel like crap and feel like a zombie walking through life. I don't want to feel like I'm in an inner circle with people and all they do is talk crap about other people because they're so insecure. I don't know about you, but I don't want to talk about people who only complain about their bills and finances. I really just want to talk with people about the adventures that they go on and how fulfilled they feel in their life and how when they struggle that they're wanting to work through it and tackle through it. I think it's really awesome that most people's excuses outside of this team are the reasons why they're not doing it. And for you, it's the reason that you are. Do you ever find that? An obstacle that you overcame, someone's using that as their very excuse. You didn't have a lot of money to sign up as a coach and join Happy and Fit, but you took the risk anyway, and now look at you. But then you talk to people who are in the same situation that you were before you started, and they're leaning on that, right? What about, I wouldn't be inspiring, I don't have a following. How many of you started with no, like I was a Facebook creep. I didn't post on Facebook to empower people. I was on Facebook to live through other people's lives. That was honestly me. That's why I loved reality TV so much, is because I wanted to live through other people, because I didn't think that someone like me had the potential to live an amazing life. I was just willing to coast. I didn't know any different. I thought that for me, what was it was teaching and feeling stressed and overwhelmed and underpaid. I thought that that was it. And I didn't said, I don't know how I can do this for the next 25 years. I don't know how I can keep up with this without becoming bitter, tired, and just full of stress. Because that's what was happening, and it was happening quickly. Now, I don't believe that this is the reason that you should quit your job, but I definitely think that you should have the choice to live your best life with whatever that looks like, whether that's with more finances, better health, a better family dynamic, saying yes to your kids and not having to say no, not having an elephant on your chest at night when you go to sleep, worrying about how you're going to pay for stuff. I don't think that's how it's supposed to be. But how cool that the only requirement to really build a solid business, and this is a business, I'm not going to try to pretend that it's not. I think that our community is the ultimate accountability. I think everybody who wants to work on their health and wellness needs to join Happy and Fit. I am like so down with that. However, there is a stepping stone if you're serious about wanting to build a business that you're going to have to put in the work. And I think that people think stalking social media and adding a couple people to their network is building a business, and it's not. And I'm not trying to be like all like coming down on you. I'm just more like, I need to create awareness around this. So let's get into it. Something, and I'm just going to talk to you about my best practices and just ask you about your best practices, and let's get to freaking work. How about that? And we can control the controllable. Right? We can control the controllable. We can control showing up for ourselves. We can control sharing our story on social media that connects with people. When we are talking to people and building relationships, we can control that. There's other things that we cannot control in this, such as if people want to run with you or not, right? We cannot control whether people give up on their journey or not. But what we can do is we can influence the rest. So we can control the controllable by showing up for ourselves and showing up in our business, and we can influence the rest. And meaning that we still show up. We still show up. When I had people quit, you know, when you're starting out, you just want momentum. You want it to be easy. And what's really hard and what you have to fight is when you're trying to go, you set out this huge goal and then everything looks like it's falling apart. That's hard to show up still. Or you had it all locked in and then you didn't. And there's going to be setbacks. And I think where you're made in this journey is that you continue to press forward with those setbacks. And that's what I did. When I would start the month off with negative SC4. You know, when I was like, I want to be at that retreat, and I look in my back office and there's 8 inactive PS coaches, right? So hard when that happens. But what we can control is still showing up anyway. Because honestly, when I look back now, I'm like, man, I'm glad I didn't cut any corners. That made me. Because you know what? I posted this quote in the team page, that it's not the destination that relates us to people. It's the journey. And let me tell you, when you hit goals in this business and you have financial freedom and, you know, you're able to pay for your gas, your groceries, and it's going to add up. My couch here is from my first like big check with Beachbody. And I was able to pay that off. And if you know my story, I grew up with not a lot of money and my mom slept on a love seat for 2 years so I could have my own room. So to have a couch that can fit so many people was like, the meaning behind it was so much greater. And knowing that was from Beachbody because of my own work, like that's awesome. That is so awesome. But when I think about all that, I'm just like, man, that wasn't easy. I just had massive belief and I took action. Yeah, Lauren, you remember that? I probably told everybody about that. Control the controllable and influence the rest. How about this? Instead of being like, Success Club isn't hard. Did I share the story about the hat? I don't know if I did, but I'm going to right now. So I heard this presenter, and I think I might have shared it. I would repeat myself. I'm a mom. And she said, man, I wish I could be a hat person. Like, I wish I could be a hat person like Brittany. Okay? I wish I could be a hat person like Julianne. And she said, what I didn't realize is that in order to be a hat person, all I had to do was what? Put on a hat. That's all you have to do to be a hat person, right? I never will hit Success Club. Success Club is hard. When you say those things, guess what? That's real. That's your reality. That's the truth of what you think. Flip your language. I haven't hit it yet, but I'm going to. It matters to me because helping 3 people isn't hard. And I'm going to help as many people as I can. Even if it's not SD6, I'm going to help as many people as I can. And I'm going to start today, right? Like, what if we start flipping the language of I can never do that to, man, I don't know how I'm going to do that, but I have belief that I'm able to do that. I can figure it out. Coined the term, it's figure outable, right? So let's go ahead and get started. It all starts with expanding your network. I don't know about you, but I started Facebook with like 300 friends, didn't post anything meaningful on it, not empowering, that's for freaking sure. And I didn't know what the heck I was doing. It made me so nervous. Has anyone else felt nervous about expanding their network? I think it's a lot easier on Instagram, to be honest. On Facebook, it was like, oh dear, because you would get those messages 1 out of 200, honestly, of like, how do I know you? And you're like, oh my gosh, this is so embarrassing. What do I say back? The more you do it, the easier it becomes. And that's just what I trusted in this. If you're not expanding your network, you're closing the door to your business. Trina Gray always said that, and I always remembered that. So every day, I maxed out on Facebook now, but every single day I added a minimum of 10 friends a day. And you're going to say, Julian, how do you do that? Let me just tell you, you just figure it out. So for me, what I would do is I would go to the birthdays and I would go to that person's birthday and I would click their friends list. And then I would just click, if we had 10 or more mutual friends, because I felt it was safer back then I would just click, 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 click. 10 or more mutual friends. Now, I don't care. I'm just gonna go ahead and request people, because if they ask me, how do I know you? I'll be like, hey girl, I don't think we know each other. I see that we do have some mutual friends, but honestly, I'm just on a mission to brighten the newsfeed because I've noticed that Facebook has gotten a little bit negative. And if someone hates that, not my tribe. Because at the end of the day, I'm just trying to empower people to get fit in every area of your life. Can we say that? Yes, yes, yes. Now on Instagram, what I do is that's what I do on Facebook. And yeah, not everybody would move my tribe when I would do that. But the magical thing about Facebook is you can unfriend and unfollow. I unfriend. I'm that kind of person. I don't just unfollow. I just kind of get to it, right? But your Facebook, I know everything's moving to Instagram, but your Facebook isn't done, you guys. You can still connect with people on Facebook. In fact, I do and I love it. On Instagram, what I do is I go to profiles that I like and I see who those people are following. So it could be a teacher profile. It could be like a Target profile. It could be a Lambo Ladies. That's a profile that I follow on Instagram. And so obviously it's Green Bay Packer fans and they're ladies. So that's who I would want to work with. You could go to the hashtag GoPackGo. And what I'll do is I almost said friend request. I'll just start following 20 people. Another way that I do that is different seasons of my life. So right now, Eric and I are trying to conceive. And so I follow a lot of that. I've had a miscarriage. So I am 1 in 4. That's a hashtag that I follow. And I'll just go follow all those people. Simply by doing that before getting on this, I had 20 new people follow me, all because I followed them. And they can see in my profile, TTC journey, miscarriage mama. So what they see is they know that we have a connection. When I'm following Green Bay Packer fan, they can see Midwest to California, but I have a green and gold hearts on my profile on Instagram. So they know that I'm a Green Bay Packer fan, right? When I'm following Rescue Dog Mom, that's a hashtag. I think it's kind of loaded with Beachbody coaches now. Or Boxer Mom, how about that? That's not loaded with Beachbody coaches. When I follow Boxer Moms, they see in my profile, oh, she's a rescue mom or she's a boxer mom. When I go to the hashtag married 3 years, married 4 years, whatever, they come to my profile and they can see that I'm married to Eric. Does that make sense? So those are the hashtags that I'm going to, and that's how I'm expanding my network. This is something I do every single day, every day. And I'm just trying to tell you that what has built my business to what it is consistency. It's not every other day. It's not once a month, once a week, every single day. And it is such a boring thing. However, there are a lot of you on this call that I would not know, and you would not be on this team if I did not expand my network. Isn't that kind of crazy to think about? In fact, maybe you wouldn't be on this call right now if your coach didn't expand their network. I think that it's so crazy. So there's this girl, I need to invite her, but I have to be honest, I'm a little bit scared. I still get scared sometimes. And I'm just going to do it anyway. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to do it tonight. Oh my gosh, I will. I just made that up on the spot. Yep, I will. And she was talking about, like, I want to personally train you, like all this stuff. And I'm looking at her post going, well, one, she'd be awesome for our community. But two, she's so geographically limited. She can only work with the people that are in her location. We have the tools to the whole United States, to Canada and the UK. And let me tell you, Beachbody wants to expand to 2 new countries a year. Like, what in the actual heck? So expanding our network on social media versus what people have to do with their businesses locally are go door to door, flyers, right? They have to do all these things locally in order to build their business. And what we get to do is we literally get to share our journey on social media, which is the best accountability. Me showing up on social media, people are waiting to see if you're going to fail and show up or not. And I even tell myself, you know what? I don't follow fads. When people say, you know, you should post one workout to, not one workout because that's too little, but you should post 3 because that's just enough. Don't post 5 because that's too much. Girl, I'm not trying to run my social media for everybody else. I'm trying to run social media for me. And if I need to post 8 workouts on my stories, that's because I need it. And you know what? My tribe is going to connect to that. So I'm not trying to follow what everyone else is doing. I'm just trying to do my own thing. And I have to tell you what, that is what has got me here. I have not been like looking. I've just been like, just do what you're doing. Do what you're doing. Just wash, rinse, repeat. Just do what you're doing. You post 8 videos and what you're finding on YouTube and other coaches teaching their teams is not to do that. Well, I actually get a lot of compliments for that. Or even if I didn't get compliments, I like it because I push harder when I record myself. I don't know about y'all, but when I have my little video on, I'm pushing way harder in my workout, and that's the kind of thing that I need. So can you guys just do you and be you and just know that that's enough? Because at the end of our lives, I just want you to be authentic. At the end of this, I don't want you to be disingenuous. Is that a word? I hope so. But I just want you to be true to who you are and not lose who you are, because you are incredible in your story, and you being you is enough. And I just think with social media, I saw somewhere that Instagram is one of the number one reasons for a lot of insecurity right now. And I'm like, ah, that's so sad. And I think that that is social media. I don't know about you guys, but there's times where I'm like feeling less than, or I can't keep up, or there's something new now. I'm tired. I'm exhausted. I'm comparing. Why can't I be there? Like, that happens. And that is why personal development is so important. But the best advice that I can give you is that you being you and staying your course is the greatest gift that you can give yourself. Team Appian Fit is one of the top teams in the network out of 400,000 coaches. And I'm honored to represent this crew. And when I'm with other people, I can see that there's a craving for significance and validation. And that is, I don't want to find validation in the praise of other people. I don't want to find my worthiness with a title alongside my name. Does that make sense? I just want to be true to who I am and true to you guys. And we can build a life of happiness and health with that. And it's really hard. It's really hard to do that with social media. So as you're sharing your story is enough. Even if it's not getting a lot of traction yet, or you feel like you don't have we can get so obsessed with likes and views and things like that, but we should be obsessed with being authentic. We should be obsessed with being ourselves. But the thing that can help you with the growth while being authentic is putting in the work to connect and expand your network. So I'm just curious, other coaches on this call who feel like they're really good at expanding your network, could you unmute and just give advice to the coaches that are on this call? How about how often do you expand your network and how are you doing it? So I'm looking for any coach to unmute and share that.
So I've gained about, I fluctuate followers because I think a lot of Beachbody coaches just think I'm the ideal candidate because I don't put Beachbody everywhere. And so I just think that's kind of funny, but that's why I'm here. But I have gained like a solid 150 followers on Instagram in the last month and just connecting with them, and they don't unfollow me. Even if they ghost me, if they don't respond, I participate in their polls. I participate in all things to interact with them, inviting them. I change out my hashtags about every probably 9 or so posts. I keep ones that keep traction, and the same people keep following me and unfollowing me and following me and unfollowing me. And I'm like, okay, what's the, so you kind of have to remember that for yourself. Like, hey, don't do that. I smile a lot. And I think that, and that's one of my biggest compliments that I give people, is that's one of the main things I'm drawn to when I'm following and trying to find people, is their smile. And can you see the creases in their eyes? I love that. And so I'm like, that's my tribe. Those are the people I want to connect with. And those are the people that I want in my life, because those are genuine. You can just tell that's a genuine characteristic that a lot of people fake when they're trying to fake it for Instagram. And so it's like, I want real people in my life. I don't want the fake ones. And just sharing constantly, all the aspects of my life. I don't have just a fitness profile. I think that this is the whole package. And so that's my mentality, is that I'm wedding planning, I'm fit, I eat 80-20, I do all the things, and I don't use that as an excuse. And so I really try to nip that in the bud. So I think that's a big thing that, has really helped me in the last month or so.
That is so good. And I loved when you're like, I love people who smile. And I loved when you're like, that's my number one compliment. My number one compliment is my hair. And when that's so interesting. What I look for on Instagram is people in hoodies. And like, if you guys know me, if you watch my, I literally don't care. Like, I am just like, I feel like my personality is enough, and I will probably wear the same gray hoodie or a gray hoodie in all of my stories, and where I just kick it. Like, I'm just chill in that way. But Maddie, that's huge that you know what you're looking for. And when someone comes to your, like, they just look happy, right? I look for mom buns. That's so good. I love that. And I think the question then from this, and I would love to see the chat blow up, is what do you get complimented for? That's what I heard from Maddie, is that her compliment is her smile. I just told you that mine is my hair. It could be specific too, where it's like, do you guys do cool braids? And that's what you get complimented on, my positivity. That is awesome. Brittany, this is something that Liz Colburn had a big realization, is she was talking about pessimism to optimism. And she's like, I saw all the other coaches posting about that, but I've always been positive. I just didn't have always a lot of confidence. And so that was a huge breakthrough for her as a coach to find her voice, is that she's always been a positive person. And she was trying to like make that shift of I was negative. Like I would say I was always positive too, but I was stressed and low energy. But I'm not a complainer. Like, Laura, we were all just, well, anyway, I don't know if I was talking about that with you. I was talking about that with someone. I feel like, I don't know if that was in our conversation at lunch. Maybe not. It was somewhere when I was in SoCal. So what do you guys get complimented for? And then own that in your stories. Like if it's hair, do like hair stuff. If it's your smile, make sure to get a lot of smiling pictures in your stories. My dogs, like put your, oh girl. Yes. I was like getting Wyatt will build my business. I'm like that. I had to get a dog. Like that's not why we got Wyatt, but everyone comes to Instagram to watch Wyatt. So think about what you get most complimented on and look for other people who are similar in that way. If that makes sense. Is there another coach that could share how you're expanding your network? Wait, Maddie, how often do you do this?
Every 9 to 12 posts. So I don't know, once ish a month.
No, I mean for expanding your network.
Oh, every day.
Every day. So how roughly, like how many people do you follow a day?
5 to 10. It's not, it's never a consistent number. Yeah.
But you do it every day. And that's the key. That's so awesome. All right. Is there another awesome coach on this call of how you're expanding your network and how often are you doing it? And whoever in me, it's just do it, because I'm just going to keep on talking, is Maddie is close to being diamond. She's on her way to being diamond. I know people, like, I know the journey to this for sure, but like you're having growth, if that makes sense. So I want to put that out there. Molly, I've been seeing you, girl. I see you show up. That's what's up. Do you send people a message right away? I'm assuming you don't, unless they have a story and you're commenting on their story. I love the comeback crew. Is there another coach who wants to share how they expand their network?
Okay, so I'm not like super fancy or anything like that, but I'm a full-time teacher, a mom of two, a wife, and so I'm more of like a pocket worker, and so I like to add to my network like as I'm walking to my car or walking into school or after I drop my kids off, I'll do like a quick adding to my network on Facebook, and I try not to overcomplicate it, like whoever they suggest for me, and we have quite a few multiple friends, then I don't even look at their profile, don't even think about it. I just add, and so far it seems to be working. And then I don't pay attention to like who adds me and who doesn't. If they add me, that's awesome. And yeah, once in a while I'll get someone send me a message and be like, hey, I'm not sure if I know who you are or not sure if we've ever met before. And kind of like you said before, I'll just say, hey, I don't think we've ever met in person either, but I just saw we have a lot of mutual friends. I see that you're a teacher too. I teach first grade. You know what I mean? And just make some kind of connection. And at first I was just like, oh shit, they sent me a message. But now it's like, I don't even care. You know what I mean? And yeah, so I'm very casual about it, tend to not overcomplicate. I don't think about it. So, so far it's just working for me, and I probably need to keep a better system of keeping track. That's probably the only downfall of doing it so casually. is that I'm not keeping track of who I'm adding currently at the moment. I just know that I'm expanding my network. And then I don't send a message right away saying, hey, I'm Steph, thanks for adding me. Usually they'll start liking my content. And then as they start liking my content, that's when I'll reach out and say, hey, thank you for all your love on my post, something like that.
Yes. So good. So good. I loved when you said, I don't pay attention to who adds me back. Neither do I would just be like, And it's only weird when we make it weird. It's only weird when we make it weird. Just being like, if someone's going to think it's weird that I'm adding like them as a friend and they find that weird with this whole social media like thing, that's on them. I'm just trying to brighten the news feed over here and you just keep on going. I love that. And Stephanie, you have had insane momentum and success with helping others get started on their journey. You also have had major success with your own journey, but you are, I want to say you're consistently hitting Success Club, if not Success Club 10. Is that right? Yeah, you're crushing it. She's crushing it. You're crushing it. Turner, what do you got? I saw you.
I was hoping you didn't see that. So I'm really busy, obviously, with school and work. I go to school full-time and work full-time. So that's like a lot. But what I do and what I found that works is in between classes, we have like a 10-minute passing period, like before my next class. So I will add to my network when I'm walking to class instead of scrolling the newsfeed, which is what I used to do. Another thing I do is right when I get home from class, I just take like 5 or 10 minutes to add to my newsfeed. Or add to my newsfeed, jeez. Add to my network. And then if I am working in like a dedicated power hour and not just pockets, I will actually add like, I'll 10x it. So on Facebook, I add 50 and Instagram, I add 100, which is a lot. And I don't do that every day, but those are the days where I'm like, I'm sitting down, I'm getting to work. I need to move the needle and that's what I'm going to do. Usually it's like 10 or 20 on each. But if I'm really trying to see momentum in my business or grow my following, I'll bump it up for sure.
That's so good. And I'm that type of person too, where I'm like, oh, if I only added 5, I'm going to overcompensate if I have more time and do a little bit more, if that makes sense. So now how do I find these people? We go to hashtags, we go to locations, we go to different profiles, right? Facebook, I just do mutual based on mutual friends. I just want to throw that out there. Facebook, my following has been 100% based off of mutual friends. Instagram has been intentional with who I follow. It is my niche. It is the season in life. It is a hashtag. It is an event I've been to. It's been whatever. Similarities, right? Which is so cool. Now, the 531, which Kim put below in the comments, I kind of do that, but I also, this is what I do. If I'm going to follow someone, I for sure like 3 to 5 of their posts. And I have found myself that I'm commenting on 1, maybe 2, not necessarily 3, if that makes sense. And if you are leaving a comment, they will most likely come back. Or if you like a lot of their posts, they'll most likely come back to your Instagram. So that's where your stories are vital and showing your personality, showing like you don't have to be a funny person if you're not a funny person. Does that make sense? You can just be chill. You can do this. I like mess up and I won't stop my recording. I'll be like, I don't know what just happened there. And that's just how I am. Like I kind of just roll with things. If there's a weird noise, I don't start it over and start a new one. I'm just like, whoo, don't mind that. Or if my hair is like, do, 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 I'm like, oh, I don't know what's happening right here. And I like fix it. But that's how I am in real life. And I'm not this like super big entertainer. I'm more of just like, just relax and I'm a homebody, like this, like whatever, relaxed, calm person. But I like to dance. I like to sing. I love my dog. I love my hubby and we love going on adventures and hiking. And that's usually what you're going to see in my stories. But then I also have my workouts on there and I am usually singing to awesome music and they love it. And I have a poll. Did you get your workout done? This is something that I'm doing differently now. And if you are a coach who partakes in my poll, you will probably get a message from me. This is what I'm doing to increase more communication through DMs. anyone who participates on my poll, a coach or not, I'm sending them a message, and you can do that directly through your poll. So if I say, got my workout done, still need to do it. Anyone who said, I got it done, I'm saying, great job, you're awesome, like, way to kick butt today, so proud of you. I'm gonna do send them a message like that. The person who says, I need to get it done, I'll be like, girl, you got this, like, you, when are you getting it done? Did you get it done? I am going to respond back to all of the people who still need to get their workout done. Now, I'm a night owl. I'm an early, y'all night owls. I can't relate. I'm about to go to bed after this. Like, 8 p.m. is what is up. Like, being like, I just cannot relate to you all who can stay up so late. I can't even drive at night. True story. It is a struggle if I have a life group and it goes past like not, like, they're all like, are you okay to drive home? Like, you okay? And I don't drink. Like, it's not like that. It's like, I fall asleep. Anyway, I'll say, oh my gosh, like, I don't know how you do it. Or, you know, I'm the same girl, same, we're the same tribe. Like, I'm interacting with anyone who's interacting with my polls when it's not an invite. Now, when it's an invite, I obviously am saying, yay, I'm so excited. Do you want more information? That's amazing. But I'm also trying to create polls to create interaction. Does that make sense? Also with my I'm gonna leave it there. So that's how I expand my network, and that's how I interact with people. Anytime I'm adding someone and they have a story, I'm gonna watch their story and interact to their story. And that's how I'm building relationships with them, when I'm commenting on their post. And this is something that has been really cool in building Instagram, is that you totally can build your business by building relationships. But remember, if you're going to wear the hat of I'm not a cold inviter, then you're not going to be a cold inviter. There's nothing wrong with a cold invite as long as it's genuine and it's connecting and it's being authentic. There is a problem with a cold invite when it's all salesy and gross and all those things. My favorite kind of invites are with the video option on Instagram stories, them being me, like, girl, I did this like 10 times today. Girl, you need to just join our tribe. You need to join Happy and Fit. You need to join this community. That is how convicted I am of this. I know what's going to happen when people join Happy and Fit, hands down. And that's how I speak, where it's like, tell me more. And I'm like, well, what questions do you have? Like, for people who've already have seen this journey, right? So that's how I expand my network. And I'm going to give you guys, the goal to be consistent with that along the way. Now I want to go into transitioning into an invite, okay? So this is expanding your network. This is vital. This is something you never stop doing. And it kind of goes with, people let the minimum requirement become their maximum effort. Imagine if with expanding your network that you didn't do it consistently, then you're going to be like, I have no one to talk to. I have no one to follow up with. I have no one to invite. I never want to get to that place. I never want to get to that space. So maybe on your power hour, it's expand your network. Then maybe it's respond to 10 stories to build relationships. Maybe it's the coolest part about the newsfeed of Instagram are those are all people you choose to follow. It's a little bit different with Facebook. Instagram, follow that news feed as long as you want, because you are following the people you want to follow. So what I'll do is I'll go through my news feed of Instagram and comment on their posts. I will like their stuff. And so maybe you set the goal of, I need to comment on 10 people I follow, their posts. I need to respond to 10 stories. Right, all in a row, right? And that's how you're building connection and interaction. Now, how do I invite? Number one, I think all invites should go to this team. I think all roads should lead to Happy and Fit. I think all roads should lead to this. Why? It's the ultimate accountability in lifestyle. Challenge groups are for accountability for fitness and nutrition. Happy and Fit is for lifestyle and life transformation. Even when people aren't ready for that, because what you're going to find in Happy and Fit or wherever your main hub is people working through mindset, people working through anxiety, people working through postpartum depression, people working through a transition. And the coolest part about our tribe is that we share that there. It is a safe space to talk about what is going on. And the coolest part is if you were to post something in Happy and Fit, you are going to get a whole lot of love. And the coolest part about posting in Happy and Fit, it doesn't have to be a workout selfie for impact. It could be any life situation. It could be any positive quote. It could be anything. In an accountability group, minimum likes, minimum interaction, guarantee it. Happy and Fit, a whole nother ball game. And that is what I love so deeply about this community, is that we are about the lifestyle. How cool is that? People who are used to quitting will less likely quit with Happy and Fit, unless they're looking at their membership as a credit card charge. Well, sure, they're going to quit that because they didn't invest in that. And it kind of goes to the whole thing. Don't just be a consumer, be a creator. Don't just consume these calls. Don't just absorb all the information. Don't just get inspired and happy and fit and just like, this is so great. I'm part of a community. Give back. Well, Julianne, I have nothing to give back. Yes, you do. Why? Life. This is all of our first time at life. You are valuable. Your story is empowering and your walk is inspiring. And you sharing that with our crew is so phenomenal. I love watching you share business tips. I love watching you share life tips. I love watching you share recipes, motivational quotes, a fun song. Lisa and Matt posting their plank challenge. Okay. And then I was like, Eric, let's do this. It was not good. It didn't look as cool as theirs, but it was so much fun and it made us laugh. And I loved it. That is what Happy and Fit is. Happy and Fit is Brittany Burmeister came to pick me up at like 5:30 a.m. in Indianapolis and drove me to Chicago, right? Happy and Fit is Lisa Locke flying on an airplane by herself for the first time to San Jose to go to a conference with me, right? How cool is that? Happy and Fit is Eric and I going to SoCal and spending time with Laura and Jason and Rusty, their dog, at the dog beach, right? That is Happy and Fit. Happy and Fit is Kim Meyer and I going to Chicago and having a blast, going to leadership and enjoying ourselves, waking up really early to do power hours. And then Kim and I walking around and I was like, Kim, you want to go get a milkshake? Because that's what I want to do in Vegas. That's a good time to me, is getting a milkshake. She's like, you got it, girl. And we did. That is Happy and Fit. Happy and Fit is when Cody came to my classroom, when that was the first time I was launching like all these ridiculous fit clubs. And she came on a Sunday. How wild. And then that's how we got accumulated and how we started building that relationship. Isn't that cool? Happy and Fit is me meeting Nikki Touch in the, I was standing in the wrong line at the airport awkwardly, and we started talking and exchanged information. How powerful is that? Happy and Fit is Ashley telling me no for like a full year on how she couldn't do this, but I believed so much that she could, and I was persistent because 92% of people don't follow up after the fourth no. Not me, because this tribe means too much to me. So with Ashley, it was a fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, no. And I was like, you've got to do this. And she did, and she's here, right? How powerful is that? It is so powerful. So how do I invite to this? One, I have massive belief in it. I can tell you all my systems. I can show you my emails. I can talk to you about my YouTube, but you will not get there if you don't truly believe that this is a gift. You are not burdening anyone and you're not being weird about it. This is a gift of a lifestyle and tribe that will get people through the hardest moments of their life. I guarantee it. And it will be one where people celebrate the greatest moments of people's lives. And those are usually in everyday moments. When I quit my job almost 3 years ago, I've been out of the classroom for 3 years in December. Hardest day. I had poured my life into that school and I struggled. What you know, it's, you know, you're taking a risk when it's not an easy decision. You know, you are doing something that is not easy when it is hard. Moving to California, quitting my job, getting Wyatt. These are all things we struggled with. We were nervous about Eric leaving his job. So risky, right? Well, on the last day of my job, poured my soul and life into this. I did so much. Not a freaking word. from anyone besides my immediate team. I look at my phone blowing up, and Happy and Fit didn't even exist yet. It was on the verge of existing a couple weeks later, but the tribe that I had that wasn't so massive, they were like, I know today is hard for you. Thinking about you, sister. I know that today is a struggle. We've got you. We're here for you. We're thinking about you. You're doing something brave. I am so proud of you. That's what was blowing up with my phone. I'm getting goosebumps thinking about this right now, because in that moment, I knew I made the best decision. Because you start to question yourself when you feel worthless. You start to question yourself when you have no idea what to do. So if there's any piece of advice that I can give you with recruiting or people coming to Happy and Fit, is having a massive, unshakable belief. And that is what I have. That has never wavered. It's always been there. And if that is something you struggle with, stick with me, sister, because I've got you. I will believe so hard in you, because what this means to me is so much. Happy and Fit wasn't here when I started. This is my vision. You are my vision. When I became a coach, I didn't have, it was literally just me. And I was like, I see it. I see the tribe that I want to surround myself with, and I will get there. And I could have followed fancy ways that teams, how people are building their teams, the quicker way, you know, and I'm like, that's not my tribe. My tribe is so different. My tribe is so authentic. My tribe cares about life. Stay the course, Julianne. Stay the course. Have massive belief. People quit left and right because I didn't know what I was doing. Not meant to be a part of the tribe, because I have a vision. I'm not quitting because other people are quitting. I don't look at this as a credit card charge. I don't look at this as just to lose weight. I look at this as to help me in life. And that is how I invite. So I can talk to you about my systems since I have 2 minutes left, and this is helpful, is one, that's how I talk about this. If you post on your Instagram stories and go, team call, no one knows what that is. When you post, oh, just did personal development, no one knows what that is, right? You have to be like, man, I just jumped on a call for an hour, connecting with a community that was breathing belief in me. I never knew how to dream until this team, right? I always struggled with scarcity, or I didn't want to build a business because I didn't know how to, but joining this kind of team and us having a weekly call has given me the confidence to do that, right? You share with people what you learn and what you're about and why you like it. So I talk about the tribe. I talk about the tribe and why I love it. And I always say to people, you got to join Happy and Fit. And we're like, what's Happy and Fit? And I was like, oh, got to check it out. It's awesome. So I have a funnel system. It's this. Anytime I post about a challenge group, or anytime I talk about Happy and Fit, it's going to one video. And this video is talking about this. And this video talks about how you get started and how I got started, right? And you guys, we have a coach sneak peek you can put people in when you're not. It is so hard to talk about this your first few times. In fact, it took me about a year to get comfortable with it. The ultimate goal is the team. What is gonna build what you want in this is the team. Build your confidence, build your tribe, everything. Everything is built with the team. And it is the ultimate goal, and you got to lead with that. But we have so many resources. I use the sneak peek. Hey, I'm going to add you to a group, and I'm going to tag you under a video. It's going to give you all the details. I'm so excited for you. So that's a tool that I use. But the thing is I have to ask. So I'm going to ask right now. I've never talked to this girl about coaching. And in fact, I want to say that I have, and then we'll get off. In fact, I think, oh my gosh, I can't even think of her name right now because I'm so nervous. I got it. Okay. I was secretly hoping. My face is really turning red. I'm intimidated. It's not always easy, but let me tell you this. I'm going to do it because 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, I love this tribe. The answer is always no if you don't ask. And I just have to say that I would be willing to get 100 no's to get one yes for the right person. And so we just have to do that. Ashley, what is up, girl? Hey, I just saw your post. It was so good. And I'm so excited for you. Question, have you ever thought about taking your personal training online so you can expand to a greater reach other than a geographical location? I think you would be so good at it, and I would love to talk to you more about it. Done. I don't care. Whatever. It's done, right? There we go. There we go. Thank you. Thank you. She ghosts me. She ghosts me. And if she watches this YouTube video, Ashley, girlfriend, whoo, would love for you to be a part of this tribe, right? Then if she responds saying, hey, yeah, I would love more information, I would probably send her a couple more voice messages, just talking about like asking her a little bit more questions, right? But at the end of the day, I am willing to do something that's so outside my comfort zone and nerve-wracking to get to here. And if there's anything I can tell you, that is how I've gotten here. And it hasn't been easy. It hasn't always worked out. And it hasn't always been as magical as it looks. But my belief in this, and you guys, we haven't even gotten started yet. We have not gotten even started yet. But I just want you to know this. There's no time to play small. There's no time to play small. You are awesome, and you are a leader once you decide to be. Leading is simple. Leading is just being transparent. Leading is leading with authenticity. Leading is just leading with your consistency. And for me, I didn't always know. I still don't know everything. You'll ask questions. I won't always have all the answers. I don't need all the answers to be a leader. What I need to be a leader is just to share my story, believe in other people, and keep showing up. And if there's anything I'm good at, it's consistency and showing up and having massive belief. You all are just incredible. And I feel so honored to be able to be on this journey with you, because we get to make an impact of health and wealth and life and happiness. And it's just really cool to do that with all of you. So I'm going to hit